Bernie Rhodes that spotted me on King's Road. Because I had an I Hate Pink Floyd t-shirt on, and at the time that was considered, ooh, how outrageous. Took me to the shop, and I mimed to a couple of Alice Cooper songs, and there it was. Yes, A Star Is Born. What a damn good band we were, to be quite frank, and how right it was that we ended when we did, because it would have been really futile to have continued with it. We all knew that. You know, bad management didn't help, none, and the in-house squabbling amongst each other. It's just the way it is, and you know, when you like feel like you're running out of ideas, then you must stop and go on to something else, which is precisely what all of us did. We were just a mishmash of everything, bunged together in our own little haphazard way. I suppose it, like the Sex Pistols really was the Steptoe and Son of the music business, and I've more or less continued to be that way. God save the Queen! The fascist regime! It made you a moron! Potential hate bomb! God save the Queen! How very little Malcolm had to do with it, and how much praise he's accepted on his own behalf since. We wrote the songs, we did all the work, we did the gigs, we led the lifestyle, and he just seemed to have collected the accolades, which... well, for a certain point as well, he tried to collect the money as well. But I fought that court case and won, on everyone's behalf.
At that time, culture was very lazy. What we saw was very blasé. And suddenly, a group like that, that were part of a feeling that was happening on the streets in the King's Road, of which they were just characters of, right, decided to express that discontent through my help.
He deserves his concrete slippers, but I'm not going to be the one to give them to him. It's the way society overreacts because it suits itself. I mean, well, the Bill Grundy thing, that incident. That was probably that old swine trying to make for good TV. It backfired on him. And that we counteracted him, we could play a far better game of chess, verbal-wise, than he could. We beat them at their own game. Something I'm still very good at.
What? Are you serious? Or are you just making me,
no,
trying to make
gone.
Me laugh?
Gone.
Really?
Yeah.
No, but I mean about what you're doing.
Oh, yeah.
You are serious?
Mm.
Beethoven, Mozart, Bach and Brahms have all died.
Bars, yes.
Really?
Oh,
what are we saying,
wonderful
sir?
Wonderful people.
Are they?
Oh, yes, they really turn us on.
What do they do?
Well, suppose they turn other people on.
That's just their tough trick.
It's what?
Nothing, a rude word. Next question.
No, no, what was the rude word? Was it really? Good heavens.
It was just in-house squabbling. Basically, at that time, the band did the music and I just wrote the lyrics. Malcolm didn't particularly like the lyrics I was writing, so sod him, I said. But he tried to use that against me because he knew the other members of the band like a lot longer than I did. We're talking about the Glenn Matlock period here. And it led to all kinds of animosities. And anyway, Glenn had to leave. Let's just leave it at that. Sid joined. Sid couldn't play not to save his life. I thought that was a brilliant aspect to our career. And it drew to a head when we went to America. The very last gig I did, I said to the audience, ever get the feeling you've been cheated? And I meant it, and I still do to this day. The whole thing went sour. We were being turned into the Rolling Stones. I found it offensive. It was too show busy, it was too organized, it was too grandiose, and it was away from that kind of rootsiness that I like about music. I like that raw edge. I don't like polished surfaces. So we split. It's all rubbish. It's all myth, isn't it? Yeah. Along with, like, Sid was supposedly this outrageously violent person. Of course he wasn't. Sid couldn't fight his way out of a paper crisp bag. A joke. I called him vicious after a pet hamster I once had. And that thing had no teeth and couldn't hurt you if it, no matter how hard it struggled. Just like Sid. A sweet boy, misunderstood.
Vicious is a good word to describe me. I'm not good at fighting, but if I get somebody in the, if I get somebody on the ground, then they are finished. You know what I mean? If I beat somebody, I beat them bad.
It appears that way when you look back on it now, just, you know, how manipulated we were by record companies and particularly the press. But at the same time, we just went along with it because it was amusing to us. Myself, I think I'm quite bleeding excellent, but to be really brutal, I think Dave Bowie should give it up immediately. It's quite sad. Just a Gigolo, I think, was one of the all-time greatest turkeys I'm proud to have on video. I can watch it over and over again. It is grotesque. The other thing, of course, Sting. My God. Heaven, help him. Somebody tell him. How can they be such planks of wood? Oh, yes, and of course there's Mick Jagger as Ned Kelly. That was a real work of art. Look, what happens with them, I think, is that they can't get out of their own egos and they don't enjoy the film part for what it is. They can't throw themselves 100% into just being that character. They're too busy, you know, looking for their best side. This is mine, by the way. And it doesn't work.
Mad! Mad! Why the hell did you go and see her?
It would have made her suspicious if I hadn't.
Crap! By going, you've made her suspicious.
Don't be falling an uproar. I didn't say a thing.
You don't need to. I can see it in your face. You just need to confess.
You go out?
And why the hell shouldn't I?
Because someone might see you!
No one's seen me. What do you expect me to do? Stay here all day on my own?
What'd you buy?
Just a few things. By the way, I think we should get a television.
The work that came out of it was quite nice. I mean, I like the film, I do. I can still watch it. But it really was too difficult. I don't like making movies. I give up immediately. I cannot bear the idea of hanging around for 12 hours a day, just literally shaking with nerves, because you do. To just shoot 2 minutes of footage is ludicrous. It's too much pressure. You know, you get very close to a nervous breakdown. And there's a lot to be said also for why good actors have no character. Because they can't afford to, not if that's their career. They get no time to develop themselves as human beings because they're constantly living other people's lives. Now that, I found utterly loathsome, because, I mean, the idea of supporting a bank robber, you know, someone who was sort of responsible for leaving the train driver's brain dead and dying, I'm sorry, I cannot support that. And secondly, he got caught, which is even more appalling. I can't have that in my life, that kind of failure, that kind of cheesiness. You know, I'm up, way up there. I don't want to hang around down there with the squalor. This is something Malcolm never ever respected, that working class people do have a sensibility and are very repulsed by things like that. It might sound nice to him in his middle class morality. Oh, it's all so trendy and chic and hilarious, but it isn't really. You know, that could have been my father driving that train.
Hello, who is it?
I was coming to see you. I went up.
Here, who is this? An army arriving?
Hold on.
Hello, did you?
Shake hands.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello, you're the sex president,
are
you?
Yeah, I'm
Rotten. You don't look anything like Johnny Rotten.
I don't f***ing want to.
You know, if you didn't swear like that, you could be another Spencer Tracy.
I thought you were asked the famous question, where's all the money?
Where's it? Yeah. Yeah.
I've done it down the boozer, didn't I?
How much did you get away with it?
All together.
Tons.
2.5 million. How much have you
We're on our way, we'll soon be up with you.
How much have you made, Joe?
Oh, we've got a lot of you, didn't get any.
Crime is strictly for mugs.
Yes.
Get into the pop world, that's the thing to do.
Yeah.
Don't go around nicking bikes and things like that. Get yourself a guitar, the honest
way. Rob them legally.
It was vile, it was awful. What a non-truth of a movie. There you go, that's an Oxford graduate or undergraduate, whatever he is, making this silly, non-realistic film. You know, I mean, we are still alive, most of us, and there we are being misrepresented in a grotesque way. I wanted to fight that in court, but again, you know, it's... I don't have the money to do this kind of activity. If I did, then I would have no doubt won, because it was a degrading, stupid, lying piece of cheesiness, bearing no sense of reality whatsoever. It was his fantasy, you know, probably like the youth he never had. He was trying to live through us.
Swim.
It's a shuttle service, really, isn't it, of activities, and that's all we are, is just product going down the line and stamped, and oh yeah, well, I don't think we need this one anymore because they're arguing that they deserve more money. That might be righteously so. Let's get rid of them and deal with the next. On and on, ad infinitum. The process just seems to be getting absolutely worse, actually. When you see manufactured outfits like Bros, and to be quite frank, they don't have a song to save their life. The lyrics are piss poor. The tunes, if you can find one, well done, are kind of haphazard based on what was currently popular over the 3 weeks period before. It's very much like the ABBA thing, but now the shuttle service has speeded up. I find the whole thing really, really annoying and disturbing that young girls are throwing their money away on something so dull as a pretty face. Hold on, just take a few seconds. Now this envelope here, there we go. That's the Lydons when we were young, me and my brother Jimmy. Isn't that sweet? Don't you think? I'm the fat one. I mean, look at that, really. How could you remember looking like that? Spandau Ballet, remember when they thought they were ever so fashionable wearing tartan? There I was at the age of 3. What can you say? I'm ahead of my time. It's different, and it's constantly changing, and it has to. It's experimental without being arty-farty about it. It's not designer theatre. It's as it happens. It's a quite natural occurrence. It's mostly instinct. As well. The songs are very instinctive, and we write specifically about situations that involve us as people, well, or whatever people I'm working with, because I am, or have been up until now, the consistent factor in public image. That could change at any one point, but the idea of public image going on will always be there, I think. It's an umbrella of activities. You must have variety, or otherwise it's all completely tedious. And I'm very lucky that the job that's been given to me, from God, no doubt, God knows who, allows me that freedom to just do what I want. And that hopefully entertains people, and hopefully shows them that there is more to life than just banner waving and sloganeering and joining stupid political groups and all that rubbish. I'm not going to do a Dave Bowie on you and say, yes, that was my Ziggy Stardust period and this is like the new whatever. That's all rubbish. It's just a nickname, isn't it? I'm me. I obviously will change as time goes by because that's called natural progression. And I think to deny that and to pretend that you're always going to be a 17-year-old spotty git is really quite stupid. Look, I really enjoy what I do, right? I make records because I want to make them, not because I think that's what the public want to hear. If the public like it, then that's all well and fine and good. If they don't, well, then I just have to live with that, and I live quite successfully with that.
Over into enterprise. This is not-
I went there because of the police harassment here. I was sort of forced into it. It really was quite bad. In less than 3 months, I was raided 4 different times. They completely smashed my house apart each time. They killed my cat with their bleeding stupid drug dogs, who tore the damn thing to pieces. They tore up the mattresses, the carpets, wrecked the doors, and they keep on doing this. And I thought, look, you know, this isn't healthy. I've got to get out of here. Because I was getting no help, really, from, like, we'll say, the music press. I tell them these things, and they just didn't want to know. So I felt completely left out there in the wilderness. So I just packed my bags and sodded off.
Could be wrong. I could be right. Could be wrong. I could be right.
Not a rock and roller. I've always despised that term because it just implies commerciality. I don't like it. Status quo are rock and roll. Dana is rock and roll. I'm not.
Anger is an energy. Anger is an energy.
I am English. I'm probably the absolute English person because I'm not ridden with class war or class attitude. I've surpassed all of these things. I am an English individual, one that does not need a royal family. In fact, I'm really annoyed to see my tax pounds spent on her designer frocks. It costs me a lot of money when I go buy clothes, and I really get annoyed that that poncy tart goes skiing in designer outfits. It really comes out of my hard-earned pounds. And yours. In fact, even more so yours. All you people that can't get jobs, right? Look what the economy is being wasted on. Fergie's frumpy tents. You must understand that the working class, and that because the Labour Party is such a farce at the moment, it implies that to be working class means you must be unintelligent or basic and crude, and I can't agree with that at all. I'm sorry, because intelligence is all important. Why should intelligence be in the ownership of things like the Conservative Party? It's not right. All kids should learn this in school. This is the weapon the Tories use against you. They want to keep you stupid. They want to keep you down. If you do not learn how to beat this system intelligently, you never will. That is the only lesson, really, in life to learn. Period.
Yeah.
I don't see myself as an icon. That's a bit repulsive, really. I'm not the Virgin Mary with child. And I really couldn't take any of that too serious. So I'm not the most wonderful human being in the world. I just do what I want to the best of my ability. It's good fun to put yourself over as just a huge egotist, but that's all it is. Nobody could really be that bad, could they? I'm an individual, and I've always appreciated myself as such. I don't want to particularly fit into any kind of community other than my own self-made image. I know what I am. I've looked at myself very deeply and very sincerely. I know all my bad points. I know what is good for me, and I know what's bad about me. So I live my life the best I can. Hopefully that impresses others. If it doesn't, too bad. Then show me another way. That's the give and take of life. What you're on about, without precaution, you'll get disease that's seen above and up till now. No vaccination can give you back your reputation.
We want your body.
We want your body. We want your body.
We want your body.